Hey guys, so I just got back from my post-op appointment, and I'm guessing by the title, you know this is not going to be a positive outlook video, so just a warning. So after my surgery, the doctor told me that he had no doubt that we were going to get pregnant now. Like, what he had done made the difference. And so, to remind you, I had laparoscopy and hysteroscopy, and my right tube is blocked, and there's a segment where it had come apart and healed back together, and he can't recannulate it because it just is too damaged. And the ovary had endometriosis, and then the back side of my uterus had a spot of endometriosis. Well, I saw those pictures today, and they were the size of the end of a, pinhead, or whatever you want to, you know, like, they were so tiny. The nurse practitioner told me those weren't going to help me get pregnant from him removing those, and that it's more about pain relief. So you could guess how I feel, how disappointed I am. And then in order to do a Medicaid cycle with them or something, it's $1,000 base price that doesn't cover medications. That's just what they charge for their office visit, a couple of ultrasounds, whatever. And I feel like that's a ripoff. I feel like that's the difference between me being able to afford medications or not. Really, I can't spend more than $500 on that period, and I haven't even gotten my bills for my surgery yet, and they were trying to rush me into it. And basically, the hope I had is, it's been taken. It's you know that thing you were told by the doctor? You know, the reason you've been happy you did this, and well, don't get me wrong, I'm glad they removed the endo, it was hurting, but it wasn't hurting my chances of getting pregnant. I have an open side. There's an ovary on that side, but unless that ovary somehow takes over, because I believe the right one's the dominant one, I just don't know. Ew. And that is a table wine blend. I decided I would get on my way home because I needed some sad wine. After I was talking to the ladies in their building department, I was just about crying because I can't afford to go there for that. I don't know if I can afford to go anywhere. I have to wait until I get my bills for my surgery. I'm not spending what extra money I have this month on a cycle, and then I can't pay my bills for my surgery. So I don't know what to do now, because what I thought was going to help and fix things and to where I could get pregnant and increase my chances and increase my fertility didn't. I just don't know what to do. I can never catch a break. Every time a carrot is dangled, this might happen and this might happen. Well, I mean, you're warned about what might not happen, but it's you never think, oh, they won't be able to fix this for me. But they weren't able to fix it for me. And I don't know. I can't hold on any longer to hope. I have to do some hard thinking because I think I'm done trying. But I don't know. I don't know what to do. I feel helpless, hopeless. I don't know what to do. I was cleared to have sex. So that's good. But I still have to wait till Friday to work out. So yeah. I'm sorry that this is sad. I was enjoying that hopeful, upbeat Molly for a little bit, but you know, that was taken away from me today. She couldn't have just, like, not said that. The nurse practitioner. Yeah, she said my endo, like, it was just these little tiny dots. I saw all the pictures. So, I don't know. My poor ovary looked so burned in that spot after he removed them. It was so sad. But I hope it heals and it takes charge and I get pregnant. But I don't know. I wanna remain hopeful for this and keep holding on. Obviously I want that, but I don't want to spend any more money on it. I just feel like there's no reason. No reason. But I will talk to you guys later. I love you. Bye-bye.